students, hope you are well at home and welcome back to the e-learning class for maths. Okay, let's start. As we have discussed about different types of views in earlier classes, I want to recap all the views once more. Okay, see, the chapter was where to look from, first chapter of your math magic, and we have discussed about different views. There were two students, Dheeraj and Anshu. Both of them has drawn the same car but from different views. Dheeraj, he has drawn the car from the top view. So that's why he has drawn only a rectangular box. Whereas Anshu, he has seen the side view of the car and he has drawn the side view of the car. So both of them, they have drawn the same car but their views were different. Clear? Now in this chapter, we will discuss about the different views and patterns as we have discussed earlier also. Okay, now I have given you one homework. I think you all have done the homework. So let's come to the homework. It was for page number 2. For page number 2, the question 1, we have already discussed that how the cat is peeping from the window and we've seen the classroom. That was the top view. And secondly, about the stairs. Yes, we have discussed that also. The first one, stairs, it was the side view. Second stairs, it was the front view. And next was the table. Yes, the table was the top view of the table, you have said. Now next, chair. Chair, as that day we have discussed, it is also the side view. Next comes the pencil. Pencil, it is the top view of the pencil which is shown in your book. Clear? Now next one, or the last one, is the bus. For the bus, we have seen it is the side view of the bus. Okay, so up to this, I think you are very much clear about the different views of different objects. From the top, how it is looking, from the side or from the front, how it is looking. Okay, so this is all about the views for different objects. Now for question number 3 of page 2, you have to draw the top view of some objects. Clear? You can take anything and you try to draw in your book. Only few things which you are using in your everyday life. Suppose you are using the pencil, that pencil, the top view you can draw. Suppose you are using the eraser, that eraser you will draw the top view. Okay. Suppose I am using the chalk to write over the board, you will draw the top view of the chalk or the pen like this. Whatever you are using in your daily life, you can draw only the top view as question number C is indicating. Clear? Now next come to page number 3. In page 3, it is given Rangoli. I think you all know about Rangolis. Yes, in many festivals, many people, they are drawing the Rangoli before their home or inside their veranda like this. Okay. So Rangoli is also following a pattern. Pattern in the sense, either the dot pattern or the line pattern or different types of drawings or figures they are drawing as a Rangoli. In your book, it is mentioned that in Tamil Nadu, we used to say this type of pattern or this type of Rangoli as Kola. Okay. In the book, there are designs also given for different patterns or different Rangoli designs are also given. So children, just try this at home. Page number 3 of your book. Even in page number 4 also some patterns or some Rangoli patterns are there. So I think you can do it very well in your book because it is very easy. The dots are given, use the dots and copy the same designs in the next page. Clear? Now for question number 2 and 3. Question number 2, use the dot grid given below to draw our designs. This also you try at home to draw it and in the book. Now question number 3, complete the figure to make squares and rectangles. This is for page number 5. Some half standing lines or sleeping lines are given which you have to use to make either the square or the rectangle or some other figures. Suppose the first one. The first one is given one standing and one sleeping line or one horizontal or one vertical line. A sleeping line, it is also known as the horizontal line. Whereas if you are drawing a standing line, that is also known as the vertical line. So for first one, you will draw a rectangle by the join the dots and draw a rectangle. Second one, you will draw a square as it is given half. So you will draw the squares. Third one, again it will be a rectangle, and the next one, again it will be a rectangle. Only the last one, it will be a square. So join the dots and form a square. This is all about your patterns up to page number 5. Next, in your math magic comes page number 6. In page 6, different objects are mentioned. With the help of the dots, you will draw these different objects. Like, first one is given a kite. You will draw a square and then a triangle to draw a kite. Clear? So this helps you to know the 2-dimensional, that is 2D figures. So with the help of 2D figures, you draw a kite, then a leaf, a flower, and boat, star, and pot. These all the figures you will draw with the help of 2D figures or 2-dimensional figures. Clear? Now next comes in page number 7. There is one story given. The story is about tit for tat. Once Amina, a girl, she went to a painter and she told that, kindly draw my picture. She had just asked the painter. Now the painter was very clever. He told, okay, I will draw your picture, but it takes 200 rupees. Amina agreed with that. So Amina, she was sitting in a place and the painter, he was drawing. As the painting completed, the painter told that, I have drawn your book, I have drawn your picture, you see it. When Amina was seeing the picture, it was only half. Why it is half? He asked the painter that, why it is half? Where is the other half? Now the painter told, yes, I will show you the other half. He has brought one mirror. He kept the mirror over the picture and he showed that, see, this is the two halves. Okay. Now Amina, she is confused. How it is possible? Now the painter, he is asking that, okay, give me my money, 200 rupees. Amina, she is confused that I have drawn only half and I have to pay the full money. Now one trick she also made with the painter. What she did? She took only 100 rupees and gave to the painter. Painter told that, why 100 rupees? I have told you 200, but why it is 100? Now Amina, she has also done the same trick with the painter. What she has done? She has also brought a mirror, kept over the money, and he told that, see, the other money is in your mirror. That is 200 rupees. So this way the painter or Amina, she has taken the revenge from the painter for the half drawing of Amina's face. So this story tells you about the symmetrical figures or about the symmetry of a picture or of an object. Clear? As earlier I have explained you about the mirror halves. About the mirror halves I have explained earlier.